Oh God.
Once again, welcome back to Animal Jones. Before we're gonna take a look at some of the animals, I wanna show you something. You know, I have told you that I have my own forest at 5 acres, but in the last few weeks, we have been digging and digging with some huge machines because I have gotten my own lake. Take a look.
Look at this, all right. I know it's not much of a lake at the moment. It's just a big hole in the ground, but over there, there's already water. There's about 1.5 meters deep. So maybe in a few weeks, okay, maybe not weeks, maybe in a few months, there are gonna be water all over the place.
That means that in the future, I'm gonna be making a lot of fishing vlogs because this lake is gonna be filled up with fish. Mostly northern pike and perch, yeah, and some small fish they can eat, roach, bream, I'm not sure the English name, small fish, you know. But later on, because I think there's gonna be at least 2 or 3 months before the lake is filled up with water. So yeah, I have to have patience. It's not easy, but I have to have patience. But let's go out and take a look at some of the animals, so stay tuned.
Hiya, come on, say hello.
Oh God! Hey, hiya.
All right, we're inside the animal house, but let's start off by looking at the pigeons.
What are you saying? Yeah, I'm thinking the same thing.
But here at my Portuguese tumblers, the black one here is still lying on eggs. Also, one over here, but I just scared them off. But there are 2 eggs in there. And over at this nest box, hopefully they're gonna start laying eggs in the future because the white cock male and one of the tricolor females are lying there all the time and yeah, doing pigeon stuff. So maybe in 1 week, maybe two, I'm gonna show you some Portuguese tumblers babies. Hopefully. They are so cute. Look at that tiny head, man. So cute. And in here with my chickens and some of my homer pigeons, not really much is going on. But I have moved the buckets over here, that didn't work. And put a nest over here. And this girl is, I'm not sure she has eggs, but she is very close to laying eggs. And down here, this homer male are still laying on eggs. There should be babies in maybe a week.
Oh, the guinea pigs are out now. What are you saying? Yeah, I don't understand you. That's the male. They're so cute. Are there any chicken eggs today?
Yeah, 2. Ah, oh, that was not big. I'm gonna leave that. This is nice.
Alright, let's take a look at the big loft. They are still doing pigeon stuff, as normal. Beautiful pigeons, but I have shown you them so many times, so let's take a look at the babies.
Down there, there is a white homer pigeon baby, growing very fast.
And in here, there are, I think, new babies. Whoop. One baby, one small one, and an egg there, probably didn't make it. Homer pigeon. It's gonna be all white, I think. Up there, there's a new egg. One egg there. One egg there. Ah, let me take you out. A beautiful, nice homer pigeon baby. All right.
In there, a Birmingham roller lying on eggs. And there are also 2 eggs there. That is also Birmingham rollers.
Let's take a quick look at the rabbits. Here we have Bella. That was the female with the 5 babies. I still have a few of the babies left, but they are being sold, but they're just not been picked up yet. And down here we have Hemelinus, and I think she is pregnant. And if she is, she's gonna be having babies in a few days. She has started building a nest over here, so I hopefully next week I can show you some very small babies from this girl. And in here, Silke is hiding at the moment. Where are you? Where are you? Okay, I'll give you some peace and quiet. She's also pregnant. And down here we have Snorkefar, the father to the babies. There, you're cute.
And down here, the last baby rabbit is. This one here, it has been sold, and it's gonna be picked up in a day or two. But these two guys are still needing a new home. They are so cute. Two small boys.
All right, and as always, let's take a quick look at the mouse.
All right, let's take a look at this family. There are a lot of mouse down here. Some very tiny one, only a few days old, and some mouse, some bigger youngs. They are maybe 4 weeks old at the moment. They're so cute. So cute. And at this top, I'm putting all the babies in when they are about 4 or 5 weeks. And then they're gonna be staying here for maybe 2, maybe 3 weeks before they are, going into a snake. Oh, sold as pet mouse. And as you can see, I have at the moment about 20, I think, down here. That is my maximum in this cage. They're only gonna be here for a few weeks, so that is okay. And look at them, they're so cute. Oh, this one I have to keep. That is adorable. But I can't keep them all, so. If you need a mouse, let me know. I have a lot, as you can see. I just love them. They're so cute. They come in so much different colors. So cute.
Aya is sad because she's not allowed in the pigeon house anymore. She is just staring at the pigeons and scaring them. But she is a cute dog.
Yeah, and as normal, my chicken are doing chicken things.
But let's go inside and take a look at some snakes.
All right, I'm in my snake room. Let me give you a quick update on the corn snakes.
I really hoped that I could show you some eggs this time from this girl, my Emil Hetskelis girl, but unfortunately I can't. She did lay eggs. She laid only 3 slugs, so 3 bad eggs. That was a terribly bad clutch and a very bad start of the breeding year. So that's just sucks. But my wild type Hetskelis girl is breeding like crazy with my snow Hetskelis male. So hopefully I'm gonna getting some eggs from this girl, the male are lying under her. So hopefully, I still have hope that I can produce my first scaleless corn snake this year, but yeah, I was up for a rough start. This girl, my snow Motley, was paired up with my ultramel to Sarah called Ghost Male, and I saw a lock between them for about a month ago, so hopefully she is gonna be sitting in a few days, and then hopefully there are gonna be some eggs with this girl. I certainly hope so. And over here I have my, the male. He is paired up at the moment with my Emil Stripe girl. So I still hope that I can get a good breeding year, but the start is not good. Here's my Emil girl. And up here I have my Ultimate Tessera called Ghost Female. And up here my Salmon to Snare of male is lying right there, and the female called Snow. Oh, Salmon Snow. Yeah, you can't see how pink they are in this lighting, but they are so pretty.
And here are my 2 pink snakes, my Salmon Snow girl and my Salmon Snow to Zero male. And hopefully, they are gonna be producing some beautiful babies for me this year. I really, really hope so. They are just so beautiful. They are my 2 favorite snakes. So beautiful. But let's give them some peace and quiet. But hey guys, I'm sorry I couldn't show you any corn snake eggs. I really thought I could, but sorry. But maybe next time my snow Motley girl had laid some eggs. But that was all for this video. And maybe next time also the blue rabbit, Hemilinus, maybe she had given birth to some small baby rabbits. I cross my fingers. I'll see you next time.